Okay, well, welcome everyone. Welcome to our webinar and demonstration today to walk through how to complete and submit the annual vessel reporting form through our MISP.io web-based platform. I'm Chris Schiani. I'm the acting manager of the Marine Invasive Species Program. And joining me today is another member of our team. So I'll kick it over to you, Jackie, right now to introduce yourself and to talk a little bit more about what we're going to do today.
Thank you, Chris. My name is Jackie McKay. I'm with the Marine Invasive Species Program here in Long Beach, California. And this morning we're going to talk about the submission of the annual vessel report form through our online portal, MISP.io. So earlier this year in October, we held a webinar discussing the proposed changes to the regulation and walked through how to set up your user account on the portal and walk through, you know, the various screens and the information that's available to you as a user. So the proposed changes were vessels or responsible parties that come to California must submit their annual vessel report form via our online portal, the MISP.io. That webinar and additional program information is available on our website. As you can see there, if you just click on the link, it'll take you to that webinar. So if you have questions on how to set up your account, you can always refer back to that webinar. So this morning, Chris is going to walk us through how to complete the annual vessel report form through the portal and then submit it to us via online. So as a reminder, the annual vessel report form is required once per calendar year, 24 hours in advance of the vessel's first arrival in California waters. So they must submit that report through our online portal, MISP.io. So as Chris mentioned, this presentation will be recorded and will be posted on our website, so you can always refer back to it if you have questions. During his presentation, if you have questions, please use the chat box and we will address those in the order received after his presentation. So with that, I'm going to shoot it back over to Chris so he can walk through how to complete and then submit the annual vessel report form via our online portal. Go ahead, Chris.
Thank you, Jackie. So I'm going to start at the MISP.io startup page. And in those previous webinars that Jackie mentioned, we walked through how to sign up, how to create your own user account through the MISP.io portal. So I'll bypass that now. And if you need instructions for how to do that, please go back and look at that webinar. But assuming you already have an account, you would come here to the sign in button, select that, read this disclaimer, hit continue, and that will bring you to the sign in page. So you would enter your email address, you would enter your password, and then hit sign in. And this will bring you to the My Dashboard page. So every single user will have their own dashboard, and on this dashboard I can see the work that I'm producing and I can see the vessel that I'm following. So for this example, to populate that My Vessels list, you would come over here to the Search Vessels feature and start typing in either the name of your vessel or the IMO number of your vessel. So we created a test vessel for this, and this is a type ahead field. So as you're typing in, it tries to predict what you're trying to enter. And so for us, we see that this is the test vessel that we're after. And you would hit add to my vessels. Then it appears in the my vessels field down here. And you can follow as many vessels as you like. So if I wanted to add more, if my fleet has 30 vessels within it, I can follow all 30 vessels and track all the submitted forms and outstanding forms as well. So from here, for the My Vessels, I will select this test vessel. And that brings me to that test vessels page. So every single vessel in our database will have its own page here where we would list all of the ballast water management reports that have been submitted and approved. all of the annual vessel reporting forms that have been submitted and approved. And for this, we had another test for 2020. It was submitted earlier this month. And if we want, we can view the report. We can make changes to the report here through the edit button. And then you can also look at the other open port calls, inspected port calls, and the details for this vessel. For this demonstration, I just wanted to point out these things up here, these green buttons where you can create a new ballast water management report to submit, or you can create a new annual vessel reporting form to submit. So we'll select this last one because that's the purpose of this demonstration. And that will take us to this annual vessel reporting form page that has tabs up here for each of the questions that we ask. And then a review tab at the very end where you can look at all the questions or all the answers that you've provided before you submit to make sure it's displaying what you intend. So we'll just walk through each of these tabs and go through the process of completing this form to see how easy it is and hopefully it's user-friendly. So we'll start with the reporting year, and a reminder, I think Jackie mentioned it, but each vessel can only submit one reporting form, one annual vessel reporting form per calendar year. So if you've already submitted one for a certain calendar year, you can't submit another one through this platform. You can go back if you need to make changes, you can go back and edit the form that has been submitted and approved, but you just can't submit a second one. So I will start here by selecting 2021 as the reporting year. I will enter in my information, officer first name, my last name, select my title, and then hit save and continue, and that will move us on to the second question. And important to remember that every time you hit save and continue, you'll move on to the next question, and you can always come back if you need to stop what you're doing, sign out, close down, come back tomorrow. You can pick up right where you left off, so it will save your progress. So question number two, since delivery, has this vessel ever been removed from the water for maintenance? So if it has not, if it's a relatively new vessel and it hasn't gone into dry dock since delivery, you would hit no. Then you would come down here, enter the delivery date, and enter the location where the vessel was built. However, for this example, we'll say that yes, the vessel was removed from the water several years ago. So we'll come down here and enter the date. So you can either click on that field and a calendar will pop up. You can populate this field through the calendar, or you can just type it in. Just remember it's day, month, year. So for this example, I will use this calendar. I'll go back to 2017 and say January 1st was the date that we were last dry docked. For the port, this is also a type ahead field. So as soon as you start typing, it'll try to predict what you're wanting to put in there. So we'll say San Diego as the location of the dry docking, and then we'll hit save and continue and move on to the next question. If the port that you're trying to enter here is not in our drop-down list, you can always type it in here. Or if you have coordinates, you can put the latitude and longitude here as well. So I'll hit save and continue and move on to question number three, where we ask, were the submerged portions of the vessel coated with an anti-fouling treatment or coating during the out-of-water maintenance or shipbuilding process listed in the previous question? So during that previous dry docking, if the vessel was coated with the full coat, you would say yes and hit save and continue to move on. If, however, that was an emergency dry docking where the vessel went into a dry dock just to repair a rudder or some other purpose, you would say either yes, the partial coat was applied during that last dry docking, or no coat was applied. And with either of those answers, we would want to know the date of the last full coat that was applied. So for this example, we'll say that it was an emergency dry docking. We didn't have any coating applied during that emergency docking in 2017. So we'll say the previous year in 2016 was when we had our regularly scheduled dry docking and had the coating applied. So then we would say save and continue and move on to the next question, question four, where we ask for the most recent full coat application of anti-fouling treatment, what type of anti-fouling treatment was applied and to which specific sections of the submerged portion of the vessel was it applied? So we're asking about the different types of anti-fouling coatings that are applied on the vessel, and we have spots for up to three different products. So if you only have one product that's applied to your vessel, you only have to use this first one. So I'll run through this, but I don't want to endorse or promote any product over another. So I'm just going to randomly type a letter, and the first one we'll select and say that this coating was applied on the sides and the bottom of the hull. And then we'll come down and do another one and say that this was applied on the sea chest gratings and the rudder. And you can put a third one if you have one, and then you would just move on and hit save and continue to go to the next question. Question five, were the sea chests inspected and or cleaned during the out of water maintenance that we mentioned? If not, and if the vessel hasn't gone into dry dock or has no out of water maintenance since delivery, then you would hit not applicable. So we'll say for this example that yes, the sea chests were inspected and they were cleaned during that last dry docking. So we will say save and continue. Move on to the next question. Are marine growth prevention systems installed in the sea chest and or the sea strainers? If the answer to this is no, you just move on with save and continue. However, if the answer is yes, then we would ask for the manufacturer and model of the MGPS. And again, I'll just randomly type a letter and pick the first one, and we'll say that this was installed in both the sea chests and the strainers. And then hit save and continue to move on. For question seven, has the vessel undergone in-water cleaning to the submerged portions of the vessel since the last out-of-water maintenance period? If the vessel has not had an in-water cleaning since the last out-of-water maintenance period, you would just hit no and move on, save and continue. For this example, we'll just say that it has, and we'll choose a date. And this time I'll type in the date. I'll say it was the 15th of November 2019. Oops, that didn't work, sorry. The 15th of November 2019. And we'll say that was in Los Angeles. And then you would provide the name of the vendor that's providing the cleaning service and the sections of the hull that were cleaned. And for this example, we'll say that it was through divers, and we'll save and continue. And move on to question eight. Has the propeller been polished since the last out of water maintenance, including the shipbuilding process or in water cleaning? If the answer is no, you hit no and save and continue to move on. If the answer is yes, you would tell us the date of the last propeller polishing. And we will, for this example, just say it was December 1st of this year. And hit save and continue and move on to question nine. Are the anchor and anchor chains rinsed during retrieval? It's either a yes or a no answer, and there's no follow-up here, so we'll say yes and save and continue to go to question 10, where we ask to list the following information for this vessel averaged over the last 4 months. So over the last 4 months, what was the average voyage speed? In knots, it was 15.5. For the average port residency time, you can either and then hit save and continue. For question 11, we ask, since the hull was last cleaned, out of water or in water, has the vessel visited freshwater ports, tropical ports, or transited through the Panama Canal? And if the answer to any of these is no, you would just move on. However, if the answer is yes, you would indicate how many times. So we'll say 12 times through freshwater, 5 times in tropical ports, and we went through the Panama Canal twice. And then we would hit save and continue to go to question 12, where we ask you to list the previous 10 ports visited by this vessel. And if the vessel is on a regular route, we ask you to select this box here and either enter in all the ports that are on that regular route. If it's less than 10 ports on your regular route, you can just input the number of ports that are on your regular route. So if there's only 5 ports that you regularly visit, you would only put those 5 ports. So for this example, we'll say we're on a regular route. We'll add visited ports here with this button on the right. And that will bring up a pop-up where we can say the first port was Seattle. And then we would come down and say when we arrived. So we'll say November 1st. When we departed, we'll say November 3rd. And then you can either save it or you can save and add another visit. So if we have up to 10 ports to enter, we can usually just say save and add another visit, and that will bring us back to this page, and we'll say next we went to Portland, Oregon, and then we'll slide down and say that this was in November as well, November 8th through, let's say we were there until the 12th, and add another, save and add another port. And we'll say Oakland, December 1st through December 4th, and then we can save and add another port, and say Los Angeles. We arrived on the 9th, and we departed on the 11th. And at this point, I'll just hit save. So you can see that those four ports that we entered are listed here. The arrival dates and the departure dates are also included. And if something doesn't look right to you, you think you made a mistake, you can always come over here and hit the edit button, and it'll bring you back to that entry. So you can edit it and you can hit save. And once you're happy with it, you hit save and continue to move on to the next question. Question 13. Since the most recent hull cleaning, or since delivery, has the vessel spent 10 or more consecutive days in any single location? If the answer is no, you would select no, and then we want you to indicate the single longest time that that vessel spent in a port since the last hull cleaning. So if, for example, the vessel spent 4 days in Oakland, you would enter that information here with this button on the right. But for this example, we'll say yes, there were several occurrences of a 10-day or more port stay. So we'll say add location on the right, indicate the arrival date. So we'll say it was sometime earlier this year where we were in port for 23 days, and we'll just say that was also in Seattle. And then we would either save it if that was the only one, or we can save and add another location. So we'll say last month we spent 11 days in Oakland. And then I'll just hit save here. Oops. And there we go. So it shows the two ports, Seattle and Oakland, shows the number of days that we stayed, and it shows the arrival dates for each of those. And then we would hit save and continue to move on to the last set of questions. And these all revolve around whether the vessel has a ballast water treatment system installed or not. If the answer is no, and the vessel does not have a ballast water treatment system installed, you would just hit no, save and continue, and then move on to review your answers. But for the example here, we'll say yes, we have a ballast water treatment system installed, and then we would come over to this button on the right that says add treatment system, and that'll bring up another pop-up box where we would enter more information. So first, we want to provide the manufacturer, product, and model of the ballast water treatment system. And again, I'm just going to randomly pick a letter, select one of these, and indicate it there. And then we want to know when that system was commissioned. So for this example, I'll just say it was earlier this month, and then we move on to the next question. Question 15 is, has the installed ballast water treatment system been used to treat ballast water in the last 12 months? If the answer is no, you would move on to the next. If the answer is yes, you would say tell us the number of times the system was used in the last 12 months. So we'll just say 12 times and move on with next. To question 16, has the installed ballast water treatment system malfunctioned in the last 12 months? So again, if this is no, then you would just move on to the next question. If it's yes, you would tell us the date of the most recent malfunction, where you would just select the appropriate date and you describe all the malfunctions that occurred during the previous 12 months. So for this example, I'll just make something up. And then you would describe the repairs for all the malfunctions during the previous 12 months. These are just short examples, but of course you would add more detail for the malfunctions and the repairs, and then you would hit next, move on to the next question. And then this last question asks about whether an onboard test for biological performance of the ballast water treatment system has been completed since commissioning. And if the answer is no, you can just save the treatment system. But if the answer is yes, then we would ask for the date of that biological performance test. So for the example, we'll just say this was the 11th and hit save. And then you can save this treatment system and all that information is here. If you need to edit it, you can go back and edit. But for the example here, we'll just save and continue to move on to the review tab. So on this review tab, it has the answers to each of the questions that you provided. And this is your chance to look through and make sure all the answers are what you intend them to be. If you notice anything incorrect, you can always go back to that question and fix it to edit it. And I'm just going to quickly scroll to the bottom to show you that if everything looks good to you, you can hit submit and it would go into our internal approver dashboard. And at that moment, you would get an email indicating that your form has been submitted. And as soon as we review it and approve it, then it would go into the database and you'll be able to see that from your vessels page. And I'll show you that in a second. But first, I want to scroll back up to show you what happens if you are missing information. So let me just go back to question 8 and say that for the propeller polishing, we didn't include a date. So we said, yes, the propeller has been polished recently, but it didn't put a date. And then I saved and continued. If I go to the review tab now and scroll down to question 8, you'll see that there's a red button here that says not complete. So that's meant to alert me that there's missing information and that I will not be able to submit the report without that information. So I can either scroll back up to the tabs and hit question 8 to fix what's missing, or I can just hit this red not complete button and that will take me directly to the part that was missing. So I'll add the date, I'll save and continue and come back down to the review tab. And now if we look on question 8, you'll see that it's complete and that alert, that notice is no longer there. So at this point, I could come back and I will hit submit and I will automatically get that email saying it's been submitted. And now this shows up in my work. It's the annual vessel reporting form for my vessel. And the status is that it's submitted. And once we approve it internally, it will then show up in your test vessel. So after we approve it, you can select your test vessel and it will show up here as a 2021 with the date submitted. And then you know that it's been submitted, you know that it's been approved. And anyone else in your organization that wants to follow this vessel can add the vessel to their My Vessel tab, their dashboard, and they can see that the form has been submitted and approved. So depending on who needs to know which vessels have submitted and which have not, anyone in your organization can do that. I think that's all we wanted to show. The last thing is if you do have issues or questions, there's a support tab up here with the help document. And we are in the process of revising this and it should be ready within the next week or 10 days. But it's live right now, it's being revised and it will definitely be completely up to date by the 1st of January. And hopefully you can find the information that you need there. And if you don't, then you can always reach out to us. And I'll just close this part of it by just saying thank you and we'll move on to the questions. If you want to search our website, you can go to the State Lands Commission's website there. Below it is the Marine Invasive Species Programs website and then contact information for me and Jackie. And thank you for your time and look forward to the questions. So thank you. So I will stop sharing. I will stop.